Like, comment, share and subscribe.
Hawaii is still in the grips of an explosive eruption as Kilauea continues to spew boiling lava, which is now surging into the streets, having already destroyed some 80 homes. Here is the latest map of the affected area in Hawaii's Big Island. Molten lava continues to surge into the streets of the East Rift Zone at the base of the Kilauea volcano, leaving dozens of homes in the Leilani Estate and Lanipuna Gardens areas reduced to rubble. Hawaii Civil Defense spokesman Talmadge Mango said the number of buildings swallowed up by the lava jumped from 77 on Thursday to at least 87 during the latter part of this week. And residents have been issued a stark warning in response to the continuing crisis: evacuate, or be arrested. The latest U.S. Geological Survey, USGS, map of the affected area around Kilauea shows the lava flow continues to surge into the sea off the coast near Pohoiki. Flows continue in the Leilani Estates area, with new lava flows reported heading towards the Kapoho area and Vacation Land Hawaii, which was partially evacuated earlier this week. Previous or notable past lava flows have engulfed that area, meaning residents could be at threat if the lava flows continue. The USGS warning for June 1 read, "Vigorous eruption of lava continues from the Lower East Rift Zone, LERZ, fissure system in the area of Leilani Estates and Lanipuna Gardens. Fountaining at fissure 8 is reaching 180 to 220 feet in height and continues to feed a channelized lava flow to the northeast along Highway 132 and down into the Four Corners region, at the intersection of Highways 132 and 137. Small overflows from the channel are occurring along its length, including in a few places near the intersection of Highway 132 and Pohoiki Road. As of 9:50 p.m. HST, the flow front was approximately 0.28 miles from the intersection. The more western branches of the Fissure 8 flow either stalled or advanced only short distances. Fissure 18 appears to be crusted over or inactive. The flows that had been moving toward Highway 137 are either inactive or moving very slowly. Fissure 22 appears to be inactive. It has been almost a month since the Hawaii volcano, the most active on Big Island, eruption explosives, sending persistent fountains of lava more than 300 feet in the air. Fissure 8 remained the most active, with lava lobes advancing some 100 yards an hour, but volcanologists monitoring Kilauea's latest eruption say the crater seems to have entered a quieter period. The summit crater, which began ejecting ash and volcanic rock in eruptions in May, seems to have been plugged by tons of rocky material which was shaken loose during the explosions. Kyle Anderson, a USGS geophysicist, warned what happened next was unknown. It's possible that new explosions will blast through the rubble at the bottom of the vent, and these may or may not be larger than previous explosions, he said. It's also possible that the vent could become permanently blocked, ending the explosions entirely. The volcano's behavior ultimately relies on the ebb and flow of huge rivers of molten rock, magma. A steady collapse of the crater's inner walls, caused by magma draining out of the summit and oozing downslope under the volcano's surface, has also greatly enlarged the mouth of the vent. The mouth of the vent has grown in size from about 12 acres, 4.9 hectares, to 120 acres, 48.5 hectares, Anderson said. Big Island's most volatile volcano has been in near constant eruption for 35 years now.